I continue the explanation of the poem After Blenheim. In the fifth stanza, the poet says, "Now tell us what it was all about." Young Peter King, he cries, and little Wilhelmine looks up with wonder waiting eyes. "Now tell us about the war and what they fought each other for." In this stanza, Peter King is asking his grandfather to tell him the purpose of the war. Okay, tell us all about. That means tell us all about the purpose of the war. This is what he is wanting to know. And little Wilhelmine looks up with wonder waiting eyes. Now, wonder waiting eyes refers here to the boy expecting to see and hear exciting things. So, expecting to see and hear exciting things. This is the meaning of it. Or you can also consider this line to be that Wilhelmine looked up at the grandfather with anticipation. So now tell us about the war and what they fought each other for. So expecting to know the cause of the war, the purpose of the war, why it was being fought. But you have to remember that grandfather doesn't know the purpose of the war. He only knows that the result or the outcome of the war was the victory. Was the victory. That's why you find in the stanza the grandfather or old Caspar emphasizing on victory. He is in the stanza making the reference to great victory, famous victory. Okay, then it was the English, Caspar cried, who put the French out to rout. So the victory, it was the English had got the victory, and who put the French. So French, they were put to rout. That means French were destroyed. But what they fought each other for, I could not well make out. So in this stanza, you find over here that Caspar, in reply to the anticipation of Wilhelmine, tells that the English, they defeated the French. English defeated the French. But he could not tell why the battle was fought. Or the only thing that he could say that it was a famous victory. "My father lived at Blenheim then, yon little stream hard by. They burnt his dwelling to the ground and he was forced to fly. So with his wife and child he fled, nor had he where to rest his head." Now in this stanza, he is narrating, old Caspar is narrating the story. What is he saying here? He is saying that his own father lived in Blenheim. And what the then beyond, yon means beyond, little stream hard by. So it's being told over here that his own father lived in Blenheim beyond the little stream. And the soldiers, what they did, they burnt his father's house. And therefore he was forced to leave the place with his wife and child. Yes, he was forced to leave the place. Or in one sentence you can say that they became homeless. Nor had he where to rest his head. That means this line indicates that they all became homeless. "With fire and sword the country round was wasted far and wide." So everywhere there was fire. Sword was being used. So fire and sword, both are referred here as the destructive element. as the destructive element. The country round was wasted far and wide. So the country, it was destroyed, or there was great devastation in the country because of fire and sword. And many a childing mother means expecting mother, then and newborn babies died. So he's saying here, the expecting mothers and the newborn babies, they died. But things like that, you know, must be at every famous victory. So it's told here that you know that such things are likely to happen in the war. So you find over here that Caspar is ironically, here what is he doing? He is ironically stating, what is he stating? That the battle took place, but again he is emphasizing on the famous victory. So he is ironically, Caspar ironically stated ironically stated that at every place, at every battle where there is a great victory. They say it was a shocking sight after the field was won, for many thousand bodies here lay rotting in the sun. And in these four lines, he is making a reference, or the report is being given of the shocking sight. And what is that report? That thousands of dead bodies, they lay rotting in the sun. They lay rotting in the sun. But things like that, you know, must be a famous victory. So such things happen. Such things happen in the war. But what is important according to old Caspar is the famous victory. Great praise the Duke of Marlborough won, and our good Prince Eugene. Why, it was a very wicked thing, said little Wilhelmine. Now you find here Duke of Marlborough, who was the English general, the commander of British forces in the War of Spanish Succession, and Prince Eugene, he was the Austrian general born in France, and he, Prince Eugene with the Duke of Marlborough defeated the French. Why, it was a very wicked thing, said little Wilhelmine. So little Wilhelmine said that it was a very wicked thing. And again you find here, nay, nay, my little girl, quoth he, it was a famous victory. So ironically, again you find Caspar making a reference to the famous victory. And every body praised the Duke, who this great fight did win. But what good came of it at last, quoth little Peter King. Why, that I cannot tell, said he, but it was a famous victory. So this poem, which is a ballad, ends with everybody praising the Duke of Marlborough. Everybody praising the Duke of Marlborough. And Peter King, he asked, what good of it at last? Means what good came out of the war? This is what Peter King is asking. Why, that I cannot tell. So the grandfather or old Caspar says that I cannot tell what good came out of the war. But he can only say that it was a famous victory. So in this poem, you find that irony is being used. In this poem, you find that irony is being used. The poem glorifies the outcome of war. Outcome of the war, that is a great victory for a nation. But this great victory was at the cost of destruction of life and property. First, stop here.